Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today I'll be reacting to Gym Leader Ed's What is the Best Coromine video, battle wise. And thank you and thanks and huge shout out to Gym Leader Ed for allowing me to make this video. And yeah, let's get on to this video. Yes, the video is pre-recorded. I can record at night, so.
Videos and sliding into the DMs on Discord asking about who is the strongest obtainable Coromon right now in the demo. Now, this is actually a bit of a loaded question because there's more to a Coromon's individual strength than just their base stat total. You have to consider its stat distribution, its type, its moves, its traits, etc. The goal of this video is to do exactly that.
Oh, true.
Individually analyze each and every one of these factors as they pertain to who I believe is the most powerful Coromon currently available right now in the demo. Now, with that being said, take a seat, relax, and let's dive right in. Okay, so just like in my best Nexomon starter video, we're not going to beat around the bush on this one. The Coromon that I believe to be the most powerful available in the demo is Patterbite. If you don't know how to
explain
Patterbite, we've got it covered in this specific video.
That's absolutely correct. Patterbite is a band. For multiple reasons, mostly because of its absolutely ginormous stats, and it has feelers, and also Propeller Punch, which is one of the most broken moves ever. It holds the title for, I'm pretty sure, for highest HP, special defense, and the rest is also very solid. Like, Armadillo is taking about 30 damage from a Fearless boosted Propeller Punch. That's absolutely mad. So let's see what he has to say about it. And what his strengths and weaknesses are.
Going over how to obtain him here just to avoid redundancy. So if you don't have him yet, make sure to check out the video that I made earlier this year on how to evolve Patterbite into Patterbite after you've watched this video. Okay, so remember how I said the base stats aren't everything? Well, it doesn't even matter in this case, because not only does Patterbite excel in the other areas we will mention shortly, it also has great base stats. It boasts the highest HP and special defense in the entire game right now, and on top of that, its other stats are all within the top 5, with the exception of speed. The interesting thing is that its speed isn't even that low either. So just remember moving forward that its stats are all extremely good, meaning that...
Yeah, but you see, the speed doesn't matter because you're using Propeller Punch for that extra knockdown chance anyway. So, that speed is technically like 50 already. So, very, very good off the start.
It's highly likely to maintain relevance beyond the current demo build as well. Now, it is a mono-normal type, which comes with its own set of strengths and weaknesses. Given that it has a very high special defense and defense stat, this means that it's able to tank it very well, with it only being weak to one type, that being poison, which as of right now is a skill type, meaning that no Coromon in the game even gets type proficiency with that.
Yeah, and while that may be true, Epiphany's leader pin is very good. Like, you just put your potential point into special defense, and summon to HP, and then let Epiphany do the rest. You've got a really strong tank, believe it or not. Like, it takes about plus 10 special defense potential points since leader pin makes it take only like 30 damage from Lunar Wolf and its Voodoo and 63 special attack. So yeah, that's absolutely insane. Once Lunar Wolf is one of its best counters as Patterbite, because Lunar Wolf resists Patterbite's stabs, its defenses are basically the same as Armadillo. So it's basically taking like 15 damage every turn. And that allows you to get lots of voodoos off. And also Ghostline before the nerf, that I'm pretty sure wasn't even a thing, was also really good because you could disable feelers with disable, and his advice would also have to repeatedly factory reset because of its defense drops from a power slap that cost time gives. That's basically its current situation in the competitive scene.
As an attacking type, Normal does lack any sort of advantageous matchup, though it is also only resisted by Ghost, which is pretty uncommon at this time. In terms of its moveset,
but Lunar Wolf is like a top tier Goromon. That doesn't really matter much. It does get a special move. Let me just show you. Okay, so let's go into Coromon. Go into here or something. Do I have a battery bit on me? Nope. Alright, let's get a bitter bite. Where are they? Oh, that's there. Sorry, subtle flex. It's just subtle flex. My perfects. If you want me to release them all, get me to 200 subs by the end of the year. That's how it works anyway. So I just got bitter bite, battery bit. It has a special move. There you are. What? I swear it got a special move before. That's weird. Okay, well that sucks. You don't need to save fellas. Anyway.
What if I told you it also gets access to a move called Feelers, which takes up a turn, but on the next turn, ensures that your next attack will do 2.5 times the amount of damage it would normally. So there's basically no real risk involved in using it. He's got defensive stats to tank any hit, then on the second turn, he deals more than double the damage it would have, should it have attacked once, and more damage than it would have, should it have attacked twice. Yeah, that's pretty good, but what if it's up against an opponent that wants to lower its stats? Well, for that, it gets access to Factory Reset, which essentially reverts all of its stat changes back to normal.
I didn't actually know, Factory Reset, only resets battle bit stats until after I did a competitive video. That sucks. That's why Slytherin is also a good counter to it, because its epiphanies will help a lot. And then obviously let me check. Okay, let's do some math over here on how the stats work. Okay, so 12.8 times chomp at poison champ is that. Let me see. Its attack is like 36 or something, so I'm going to go for 35. Times two, then this defense is like 50, I guess. Then blah times two. And there you go, 57 damage after two epiphanies. Now let's see how much it gets in return. So, times. Let's go propeller punch. Fifty-two. You know, that's armor deal. I don't know, 50. Times. 52. 50. And now I got 35 or 30 times 2. Then 50. and he's gone, and this is max damage roll, so it can go up to 8 damage, and I don't know about that, but I guess Feeler's boosted Repeller Punch does do quite a lot, but I mean it's better, right? So yeah, and also yeah, that's the damage formula, by the way, how you do the damage. Pretty sure it's like 30 now. I forgot. But I won't check.
It does have a 10% chance to miss.
You see, but the flinch is like the flinch works even if the user moved last. So no matter what, you will lose a turn, even if you recover SP. You can recover SP while knocked down, but you would still have to recover the next turn. So yeah, that kind of sucks. Oh yeah, I forgot the stat bonus. Yeah, 27, I still not that much. Then it's going to be like 12 max roll.
You want a little more power, don't worry. It gets access to a move called Base Slap, which has 60 base power.
Yeah.
And a 50% chance to cause.
Yeah, now Confusion is replaced by Haze, which basically doubles the amount of SP the opponent uses, or the user that has Haze uses. And also Face Slap is a move with a lot of SP cost. It's 6. That's a lot. Even though the haze is useful, it's not always is not useful on all Kotokoromon. Like on Houndour, it's absolutely devastating. Like it can only go for 1 pound. It can recharge. It should recharge every other turn, since power talent is 8, but it's 8 SP. It also gets like 2 SP back, but so yeah, haze is pretty good, but it's not the best. It's very good, but I guess you could use face slap until the opponent gets haze, and after that Feelers and Repeller Punch it into oblivion. That way it won't be able to move a lot. That's why I hate fighting against Peter Bite. And the name Jesus is very appropriate, like it's absolute God.
So yeah, this thing's not playing around. Despite it only getting access to normal type moves, each one has a unique effect, allowing it to excel even in disadvantageous situations. Now in terms of traits, Patterbite gets access to 3, being Conductor, Robber, and Download. Conductor allows the Akoromon to gain a speed stage when hit by an incoming electric type attack. Robber is a non-combat ability that gives the trainer extra gold when winning a battle, and Downloader will the opponent's attack stat, and if said stat is higher than Patterbite's, it'll raise its own stat to match it. Out of the traits, the best one, hands down, in my opinion, is Downloader. It comes with 0 risk.
Well, yeah, but you see, Patterbite has like the second highest attack in the game, so, second or third highest in the game, so, unless you're fighting an Armadillo, it won't increase. But at the same time, Conductor is also useless because you're going to be using Propeller Punch all of the time. But what we actually did is give Rubber a use in competitive, so that Mormon can make use of moves. So Rubber, for example, has a 33% chance to steal the opponent's fruit, and that is very, very good. Which is why I actually had to ban it. It's banned now. And it very, very, very much outclassed the other mon. Once it got an attack off, and once it stole fruit, it was just like game over. So yeah, that's That's awesome. Well, not awesome, that's horrible. But the downloader only activates at the beginning of the battle when it comes in. So if your opponent sets up on you, like me, you know, set up a few rages, then the downloader trait won't actually activate. So yeah, Rubber Peter Bite is very good if you give it the use we gave it. So yeah, every member in the server would agree. Dr. Pepper, Raichu isn't there anymore, a Spectre, Sarojo, Peter Bite is just broken beyond repair. which is a coincidence that it's a robot. It's broken. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure that's exactly what I gave it as well. But I'm pretty sure I also put slime in there, because it's not that much of a power decrease, but it also like what do you call it? It costs very little SP, so at the end of the battle, when your SP is very low, you can just go for a slime and finish up the job. So yeah, that's pretty cool. You normally just run a canoe fruit on it, and maybe go max HP, because HP is basically the best stat. Oh, sorry, best HP is basically the best stat you can invest in most mon. Like besides passer, HP is like one of the best stats. Like even Mino benefits a lot from HP. That's exactly what I wanted to say, but it was like, I want to tell him, but I'm pretty sure I'm just going to wait a little bit, so I'm making sure that he knows, that he does know. Oh yes, Step Splash is also very broken. Does like 30 damage as well. Like every time, unless you're fighting a electrical type, then it does only like about like 15. But it's still very solid. That's why you invest a lot of bulk into Sheer Tooth, and don't try to sweep with Faint Spurts, like somebody did. I'm just like so confused why we do that. Anyway, but yeah, also it instantly takes out Imbavel and Mino. Pretty sure it also does that to to Digmeow, but I forgot if his HP is higher than 62. Yeah, HP is the stat to go, and the editor in the video clearly knows that, well, partially, 84, that's plus 7. The game is currently a single player experience, so I wouldn't get too caught up with exact values. Little would you know. Also, I'm recording this video before the TMs come, so that I wouldn't judge him and make false assumptions, when the flashed skills aren't here. I am recording this on Wednesday, the 7th of July. Just do whatever works for your playstyle. Yeah, guys, there you have it. Patterbite is without a doubt the best form on your channel. Yep. It's definitely broken.
Let me know if you want to see me do one for the starters or even monsters from other games as well. And with that being said, if you did enjoy the video, make sure to like and subscribe.
I may check those out as well. Okay, so everything was fine, but that was from this point on, the audio quality started getting really bad. Not only it was just like a minute until the video ended, but anyway, Jim Leader talked about doing the the analysis on the starters, and I wanted to see how that will turn out. Let me see if I have the thing downloaded. No. There's this. So this is Sir Roger's tier list. And yeah, you can see he put Armadale as a B tier, which I definitely don't understand, as well as Slytherin being a C tier. Likewise, Slytherin is really good. But yeah, we'll definitely maybe also put what do you call it? Sheertooth up there. But like I said before, Aroar and Bezer count on it pretty hard. So besides Slytherin and Ghostlia maybe, and also Armadale moving up rank is pretty good. And this here is mine. Now Bezer does go, you know, you. Wait, I forgot about Armadale, you know, you. Anyway, but yeah, Slytherin is also you now. It's pretty good. You just have to use a good set, like Sergius Lunar with like 30 damage to my Slytherin, and since he has Mortar, it can eat a Canoe Fruit and get rid of its status condition pretty fast. So yeah, the rest is basically the same. Digno is definitely not OU, since weak to water and what are the two metagame staples in OU? Water and splash. Both have splash. So yeah, Digimon are just decimated by those ones. And yeah, that's about it I want to talk about. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget the thumbs up, like and subscribe. Thanks again for Gym Leader Ed for allowing me to make this video, and I'll see you tomorrow, and go watch his original video as well. Bye!